When we look at the Rastas, the Rastafarian movement in that's taken place in Jamaica and in the diaspora, Naya Bingi set that foundation. And for a very long time, people didn't understand what the drumming and the calling of Naya Bingi was about. But what it is, it's about invoking that feminine warrior spirit. We do not understand that the feminine energy is the hidden, the masculine energy is the seen. So when we play the drums and we sing and we feel that power, that's the feminine energy that's being called forth. And Naya Bingi is also connected with Sekhmet, who is the Egyptian lion deity, which represents that lion force of regality and protection. And so that energy of Queen Naya Bingi, her spirit is very much present now, but has also been called forth at different times when Africans have needed protection and liberation. It was when she was being, when her energy was invoked through Muhumuza, that is when Muhumuza was able to keep off and ward off the Germans for 21 years to stop them from being able to invade Uganda. So it's like that energy is there and it's powerful and it's prevalent. And so for me, she's somebody that's very, very important. And because of the fact that, you know, during that time where we were so powerful, the Western, they brought in these anti-witchcraft laws in the 1921s, which, so in 1921, which stopped us from being able to really embody our African spirituality and call on these energies. And that became the demise of our African people. That's how we began to become more enslaved. And so I believe that through my resurrection and remembrance of her, it's also up showing us that we have to not... we have to re-embrace our African spirituality, because that is the power that we are missing, you know, being able to call on our ancestors for that strength, and that will allow us to go to move forward and to have liberation. So.